What's up, everyone? It's Valok Legion. I actually had a request to do a part two to my Dark Alliance videos, even though I only got one. I had an FC mate that really enjoyed the first one, and she would like to see a second one because she's also thinking about buying the game. So, Carwen, this one's for you.
The United...
Just had to refresh my memory about the controls because it's been about a week and a half since I played this game. So, see what happens. Also, like I've said before, I play a lot of Fantasy 14. If there's any fellow players out there, and if you're on Sargantus and you're looking for an FC, come check out the Boar's Hat. That's where Carwen and I are at. And it's a very fun guild. We do mount runs, and I believe you're getting ready to do some more raids. It's just a real fun group to play. Please excuse the sound of my voice. I just woke up. I was up for 24 hours yesterday because I had to work the graveyard shift at my job, and I do not like to sleep through my days off. So I was up for 24 hours, and I just woke up this morning. And I'm sure you can tell I'm still waking up. I got my coffee, got the game going. Let's get it on.
I owe the dwarves a debt for taking me into their halls. I would never wish this tragedy on them, but at least I get a chance to repay their kindness.
We were lucky the battle hammers were poor when we arrived. Unlucky. Yes. Was it? Seems more like Providence.
What's that?
Nothing.
Ah!
Listen, they need us to hold the span.
We were supposed to battle. Not an army from Stygia.
More work to be done.
Gotta remember there is a multiplayer part to this too that I gotta check out.
Stygian Legionnaires! Infernal forces have no place in Iceborne Tales!
think I should have, woken up more before I played.
Hold.
Mother's home was a ruin. And the destruction of Bangor's span, the bridge named for his father, its loss was a heavy burden. The dwarves had to abandon their life, chased from their homes by the goblin and vermeer remnants of Kessel's orcs. These threats and worse had answered the call of Crank Shinnabon. And we were the only thing that stood between these creatures, the Shard, and the utter destruction of our home.
Now, I don't know much about D&D. I had bought the actual box game, but never played it. But some of these characters are off the wall and awesome. I can see why Carwen plays it.
Said he'd let me come with him on his next adventure.
For real.
I could have pipes like Wolfgar if I wanted to.
Just gotta get back to working out.
Yeah, some people will find out when I play these games in my videos that I find things out a little too late during the game, like that move right there. I didn't know if you held Y that it did that. So, yeah, you can make fun of me on this one, Carwen.
Goblins had begun constructing a tower to secure their foothold in Brunner's home, and had spread out from that stronghold into the Dwarven Valley. The first step to clear out the goblins was breaking into the goblin fort guarding the entrance to Rugrib's quarter. We would have to recover explosives to blow our way through their fortifications, and then take out the foreman and his Verbeeg enforcer.
Can't believe that has anything to do with Regis.
I got what you're looking for.
Yes.
Bear with me here, stumbling on my words this morning. I'm trying to figure out if there's a way to buy weapons, and I don't think there is. After playing this game, I'm even thinking about picking up Dungeons & Dragons Neverwinter. I've played it before and never really got too far in it, but this game makes me want to pick it up again. So I think I'll have to do that. And yes, Carwen, I installed it on the PS4.
This Emperor Hamburg is indeed bold if he believes he can hold this valley.
Not off to a good start on this one.
Against me.
Go to the east! Most of the insides are blocked off. Who knows how much gold's hidden away?
Who stands against me? Who young magic protects this one? This one will test me.
Continues.
So why not sign on with Russell in the first place?
I don't know. Just go right. Go right at it.
Boat. That's the shard.
That's how it works.
It makes you do stuff.
Nah, I signed up because he seemed like a real guy. Quiet the raid caravans and then deliver all the loot and prisoners to him for his own personal use.
Let's go. Enemies of the Dale!
Be all the explosives needed to blow the Compton gate.
This one
will test me. Now, dwarves, I kill next.
Continues.
So far, this game has proven pretty good to me. I don't know what everybody is complaining about. It's fun in my eyes. I just guess you have to be a real D&D specialist, I guess, to pick out the bad parts of it. I don't know, but I really enjoy it.
Right up here. How do these people?
The longer you hang around here, the less time you have to find me.
Good stuff for trade.
Did I get into hack?
You know, I only knew Regis a short while, a day or two at most, but I think you might.
Goblin. Emperor Hambuk, he called himself.
This goblin claimed to have found the shard.
But what his goblin horde was constructing was no crystal tower.
There was only one way into the canyon where Hambuk was building his tower.
Its entry was held by Goffin's door.
But the door's runestone locks were scattered across Rugrib's quarter.
And so before we stormed the tower,
we would recover the runestones.
Engage those locks on Goffin's door.
And seal Hambuk in.
Like always.
Some of the load times are long. That's the only problem I've seen with the game so far, like I said in my previous video. But other than that, I think it's an awesome game.
I imagine the goblins are enjoying getting one up on the dwarves. Time to take them down.
Ha! orders. Everyone's locked out. Thanks.
Get up, boys!
Scattered by the dwarves.
I need to recover
all of them. I use them to lock Goffin's door. Goffin's door stands guard to the King's Chasm, but the door guard and goblins invaded from within.
It's inside those runestones. Runes made the counter on the outside to foil. Yes, they're putting inside the key to their doors.
Every bridge, but the doors up! Oh, shut up, a goblin!
Are you
used to live in a hole.
Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Those dwarves ever come back, the crystal tower.
Give that a little try instead of doing the rest. See what that brings me.
For the people of Ten Towns.
Thank you.
coffin's door won't open until all the runestones are recovered.
This one will take some effort.
Collapsing the dam may have delayed the Dorgar advance from below,
but it didn't stop the goblins
moving in from above.
Get up! makes up for other shortcuts.
What are you
thank you.
Thank God for coffee in the morning. Oh my gosh!
Short on coin, I suggest you go, you know collect some.
Didn't really get anything in this one. I'm starting to think that you need to check every area on the map in order to get some good gear.
Can't believe Regis isn't back yet.
I guess if the Dale was in real danger,
he'd be here.
What do you need?
Such a dummy. I just saw the upgrade button on the bottom right of the screen. Yeah, sometimes I'm slow, people. People can deal with it. Give it a shot and see what it does.
Fresh.
So it goes up by 1 point.
All right. Looking good.
Okay, so it's fully upgraded. Percent chance when hit to release an acid burst inflicting weakened condition to all. That's pretty cool.
Nice.
That's a step up. That'll nicely.
Upgrade.
You can thank me later.
Now you might not die so fast.
Now you might not die so fast.
Okay, the set that I got is fully upgraded. So, we'll see how that works out.
Always a pleasure.
Hopefully that makes it a little bit better. But that'll do it for today. And Carwen, I will do a part 3 for you. Because I know you're a Dungeons & Dragons freak. And, as always, I am one, as we are many.
When are you going to bring me some more junk?
Please leave a like, and please subscribe.